Praise the Lord, everybody. This is Sister Melody back with you. And we have something a little bit different and special today. We are going to have, it's geared towards a younger group of people. So if you feel young or young at heart, then you'll need to get up and do the actions with us as much as you can. This will help you to burn off some energy and to get some feelings out. We're going to first pray that the Lord leads us and guides us. And then we'll go on to that. Lord, we ask that you would touch and move right now in every person's situation out there, Lord, no matter what they're going through. We pray that you lead them and guide them, give them guidance, Lord, give them your love, and help them through whatever situation they're facing. Lord, we know that you are the master of all, and we're leaning on you, Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, now you're going to need to stand up and move yourself away from each other so that you can do some of these actions. And I had some helpers with me, so you just enjoy this, and we'll see you soon.
Thank you. y'all ready for a song from the Puppets?
Yeah!
All right, let's get them woke up. We're on the count of three. Everybody holler, wake up! One, two, three!
Wake up!
Wow. Y'all want to sing a song?
Yes. Yes. Yeah.
All right.
Easter is already here.
Me neither.
Hi, Ellie.
So, speaking of Easter, I've made a list of everything that I would like.
Oh, really?
Well, yeah. I would like Susie's Smiles doll, a sparkly purple bicycle, a fishing rod, a skateboard, a Toby Mac CD, a teddy bear, lots and lots of candy, lots of eggs to color, not brown though, muddy looking ones from those chickens you have. Got it?
Wow, Ellie. Don't you think it's a bit much?
No. It's much shorter than my Christmas list was.
Yeah, I noticed, but still. The holidays have become so commercialized that people are forgetting what it's really about.
I know what Easter is about. It's just not about getting gifts.
You do?
Yes, it's also about getting candy and an egg hunt.
That's not what I meant. Let me tell you a story that might help.
It's about time.
Okay, the story was taken from the book of Mark, chapter 14 through 16. They were to the part where Jesus was taken prisoner.
Yes, Judas betrayed him. He brought him a bunch of bad guys to the garden where Jesus was praying. His disciples who were with him should have been praying, but they kept falling asleep. When Judas saw Jesus, he pretended he was happy to see him and gave him a kiss so that the bad guys would know which one was Jesus and could take him away.
Wow, that's right, Allie.
I heard you talking about telling this story, so I thought I would learn about it by reading it in my Bible.
I'm really proud of you, Allie. It's good to read God's Word.
And then the disciples took out his sling and with one little stone struck down the biggest, baddest guy of them all. The others were so afraid that they took off running and left Jesus alone.
Let me guess, you didn't finish reading the story.
My Little Pony come on, and I had to go watch it. Then I got hungry and needed a snack. After that...
I get it. Sometimes when we're reading our Bible, it's easy to get distracted. It's good to say a prayer asking God's help to stay focused. Anyway, back to our story. The soldiers, they came to arrest Jesus, and his disciples forsook Jesus and fled. Jesus was led away to the high priest, and with him were assembled all the chief priests, the elders, and the scribes. They looked for testimony against him so that they could have him put to death, but none could be found.
Ha! That's right. So they let him go.
No. Many gave false testimony against him, but their testimonies did not agree. The high priest stood up and asked Jesus, saying, "Do you answer nothing? What is it these men testify against you?" Jesus knew the scripture had to be fulfilled, so he kept silent. Like I wish you would.
How rude!
Again, the high priest asked him, saying to him, "Are you the Christ, the Son of the Blessed?" Jesus said, "I am. And you will see the Son of Man sitting at the right hand of the power and coming with the clouds of heaven." The high priest tore his clothes and said, "You have heard the blasphemy." They all condemned Jesus to the deserving of death.
Whoever said the truth will set you free was wrong.
They weren't interested in the truth. And you have to remember, this was all part of God's plan. Throughout the night, they hit Jesus and spit on him. And in the morning, they took Jesus before Pilate, demanding that Pilate simply agree to the death sentence they had pronounced on Jesus, but Pilate refused.
Good for Pilate. He let Jesus go, right?
No, Pilate wanted to, but the chief priests stirred up the crowd so that Pilate would release Barabbas to them instead. When Pilate asked them again, "When they do you want me to do with him whom you call the King of Jews?" they cried out, "Crucify him."
I'm out of here.
Why are you leaving?
I don't like this story. It's horrible.
As horrible as the events that took place were, it's actually a very good story, so please be patient.
Okay, fine.
Pilate delivered Jesus after he had scourged him. To be crucified, the soldiers led him away. They clothed him in purple and placed a twisted crown of thorns on his head. They struck him on the head with a reed and spat on him as they mocked him. Then they took the purple off of him, put his own clothes on him, and led him to crucify him.
I'm still not seeing the good part about this story.
Patience, patience. We know that Jesus suffered and died an awful death on the cross after he died. A man named Joseph went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. He wrapped him in linen cloth and laid him in a tomb cut into the rock where no one had ever lain before.
Still not seeing it.
Wait. When the Sabbath was passed, Mary Magdalene, along with certain other women, brought spices that they might come and anoint him very early in the morning on the first day of the week. They came to the tomb when the sun had risen.
I don't like getting up early. I always sleep in on Saturday mornings. I would sleep in during the week too, but my mom makes me get up for school. I don't know why. School can't start later. I mean, after all.
Can we get back to the story?
I was just trying to add some interesting points.
It has nothing to do with the story.
Sure it does. They got up early. I have to get up early.
Please, Allie.
Okay, fine.
As they came to the tomb, they wondered who would roll the stone from the door of the tomb. But when they looked up, they saw that it had been rolled away.
Earthquake!
No, no. Entering the tomb, they saw a young man clothed in long white robes sitting on the right side, and they were alarmed.
Sound the alarm! Sound the alarm! It's grave robbers!
Must you, seriously?
I'm helping.
No, you aren't.
You're kind of grouchy. Did you get up on the wrong side of the bed this morning?
You're interrupting.
Fine.
The man said to them, "Don't be alarmed."
Too late.
You see, Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified, he is risen. He is not here.
Yeah?
They went out quickly and fled the tomb, for they trembled and were
afraid because the man was after them.
No. And actually, the man was an angel. In Luke, it speaks of two of them.
Oh! The two angel men were after them.
Will you cut that out? The woman fled from the tomb, and they trembled and were amazed. You see, Allie, when Jesus rose from the dead, it was one of those final steps towards mending the separation between us and God, because sin and death had not been defeated. And that's why we celebrate Easter.
You're right. It is a good story. I was thinking about the egg thing, too. I guess mud-colored eggs wouldn't be that bad.
Would you quit worrying about the eggs? Just don't forget the real reason we celebrate.
Okay, I won't forget. How about all the other stuff on my list?
Really?
Just kidding. Bye!
We're so glad that you have stayed tuned in with us. We hope that you enjoyed the skit that was prepared by Brother TJ and Allie. They did a great job, didn't they? Let's give them a hand. Good job, y'all. Just like in the story, Jesus loved us so much. And he showed that love by dying on a cross for us. He died so that we could make heaven our home. And the true meaning of Easter is that he has died because he loves us, and he's risen again and prepared a place for us. And what we need to do, every one of us, no matter what how old we are, how young we are, we need to ask the Lord to forgive us of any wrongdoing that we've done. It could be as simple as you lied about something. You took something from somebody. The simplest things. God just needs to know from us that we are sorry for what we've done. And that that's what it is. It's repenting. It's saying, "I'm sorry and I'm not going to do that again, Lord." And then we ask Jesus in our hearts. We get baptized. We get baptized in the water in Jesus' name for our sins to be washed away. And then Jesus can come into our hearts and live with us and stay with us forever and ever. And we can make heaven our homes. That is why he did this, so that we could be with him forever in heaven. So this is what we need to do. Every person, not just little, old, young, middle-aged, every person needs to do this. And we have to do it daily. Because sometimes, you know, we make mistakes and we fall. But Jesus is there to hear us and to listen to us. And we ask that you would do that even with your parents at home, wherever you're at, grandparents, whoever you're with. And let's just bow our heads right now. We're going to say a prayer, and then you can talk to us later if you would like. Dear Lord, we thank and appreciate you for bringing this to our light of our eyes, Lord, for leading us and guiding us, Lord. We pray that you would help each and every person out there, young or old alike, middle-aged, no matter who it is, God. We know that you are tugging at people's hearts. And Lord, we ask that you would touch as many as you can with this ministry. We thank and appreciate you, Lord. We pray that you would help each and every person, Lord, to come to know you better throughout their life. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.